How's it going, guys? Welcome back. Today I want to show you guys how you can change your IP address. Okay, so let's start with the Mac. Now I'm not on Mac, so just follow my instructions. Click the Apple menu and open the System Preferences. Select Network. Highlight the network that you're connected to in the left panel. Click Advanced. Select TCP/IP and click Renew DHCP Lease, and you are good to go. You will now have a different private IP address. Okay, so now on Windows, just go to CMD, run as administrator. I'm not going to do it right now, but this is what you do. You hit ipconfig, okay, /release. And that will release your IP address and it will disconnect you from the internet. Once you're done with that, and you know, it kind of shows all kinds of prompts here and there. And once it's done, type ipconfig /renew. And click enter and you're good to go. Now you will have a new IP address. Okay, another thing you can do is simply unplug your modem to change your IP address. And if it doesn't work, just leave it overnight. And if that doesn't work, then you should just ask your ISP to change your IP address for you. One more way to change your IP address very easily is simply change to a different network. You know, you can switch to a different Wi-Fi or use your mobile phone. You can turn on the hotspot on your mobile phone and use your mobile data, and that will give you a different IP address. Now, of course, you can also use the TOR browser. Once you download the TOR browser, it will give you also a new IP address. The Onion router is, of course, one of the most reliable ways, actually, to hide your IP address. But the problem is that it's a little bit slow. And that's the only downside to it, is that it is slow and it's just, you know, made for web browsing, not really downloading or streaming. So yeah, but you should know one thing is that typically the Tor browser is how people access the dark web, and the dark web is typically associated with illicit activities. So you might get a warning from your ISP, which is why it's always best to combine the Tor browser with a VPN so that you don't let your ISP know that you're using the Tor browser, because while the Tor browser might hide your IP address, your ISP can still tell that your real IP address is connected to the Tor browser, okay? Another way to change your IP is by simply going to your proxy settings. So let's say here, proxy settings, okay? Use proxy and look up some free proxies and you are good to go. So you can use HTTP, HTTPS, SOX 4 or SOX 5 proxies, depending on what you're looking for, and you'll find a whole bunch of proxies. But the thing with proxies is that they won't encrypt your traffic. And again, you have a whole bunch of people using these free proxies, so you never know who is using these proxies to do some weird activities that you could be associated with because you're using the same IP address. So again, not really the best way to change your IP address. Wouldn't really recommend it. The best way to change your IP address, honestly, is by protecting your IP address and protecting your traffic and online activities using a VPN. These are the best VPNs you could use. Of course, this isn't my real IP address, but the way I hide it is by simply connecting to one of these servers. Let's say this time I want to connect to the Swiss server of ExpressVPN. It's as simple as just clicking a button and my data will be protected. Definitely one of the biggest reasons to hide your IP address using a VPN is to protect yourself on public Wi-Fi or if you want to access streaming services. So there we go. Now I'm in Switzerland. It's really as simple as that when it comes to using a VPN or hiding your IP address using a VPN. These are the top VPNs in the business. They've been at the top for a while and they still are. So if you guys are interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find the top three VPNs video for a full review on all three VPNs if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs. You'll also find links to pricing and discounts if you'd like to take advantage of the discounts while they last. Besides that, keep in mind that they do have a 30-day money-back guarantee if you'd like to try out the service risk-free, and they have 24/7 live chat support to help you out with that. And if you have any questions, feel free to comment down below. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.